And therefore, what kind of games and maps do they have? Nyan and Trueloque. Alfheim, Tundra, Drenched River, Blue Lagoon and Merit. Okay. Doesn't need to be right now correcting the names. Up top. So you can iron, then it's gonna be TM Trueloque. I think it's still TM. And therefore, right after, you're gonna be having another match between NyanRacingCat and Trueloque. Also from the first round, all the matches this week are gonna be from the first round of Gregg Open Tournament with Kronos and Zeus, so obviously gods that the players are known for. NyanRacingCat is definitely Kronos main, then, well, Trueloque is of course Zeus main as well. So not really all that much of a surprise in there at all. So let's see how they're gonna be meeting up, because quite frankly this is an interesting matchup between them. They are both really reasonably solid players. And you could be considering that Zeus could be a good match against Kronos, but Kronos got a few buffs in the Wubble Lands patch 4.0 that we are right now playing on. He got cheaper time shift of fortresses and towers, basically cut in half. So I'm gonna be looking forward to potentially NyanRacingCat using it somehow. As right now, for example, on a map like this, it might be coming into play, an undeveloped passage from the Zeus as well. But you're probably gonna be getting a bit longer games here this time around. We'll see. Unless there's gonna be some brutal crush or Athena rush or anything like that. Because Kamala Trueloque does like to be playing aggressively when he can. So it's not like he's not knowing how to do that at all. And Archibalista, Kerobalista, LS and range, that is actually fairly important. Especially looking, for example, at the Kerobalista there. So obviously Kronos does have the bonus for them. So it might be useful. Might be useful relic all around. And there's gonna be another one for favorite trickle. And there should be about like two more somewhere hidden. They're gonna be meeting each other. And Trueloque probably gonna be getting right now the extra Kaui. Exactly, he should be. And much more important, he could be even trying to disrupt the oracles so that they cannot be valored all that easily and all that simply and quickly in the game. Otherwise, kind of like the standard strategy could be for Trueloque as Zeus against Kronos. Some kind of Kentaur raiding. I mean, like, why not? It's Alfheim, it is a bit more closed map, sure, but against Atlanteans it's still quite a good idea. So let's see if he does have the bravery to go for that. It's quite an interesting gold with a bit of hunt in the corner of the map, available for Nyan. And he does have even more gold mines in this way, and in this part of the map. Problem for him bit is no problem. Kinda however you take it, it almost seems like that this DC is supposed to be Nyan's as the front one. He could be getting at least this gold from it, and kinda like halfway this. Also not too bad, it's in the middle of the map, but still fine. But considering that with this one, they are pretty much on the same level, it's not gonna be all that much of a surprise if, for example, one of them decides to be going basically on the opposite side than what I'm so far right now expecting. The back DC here is definitely one of the safer ones for Nyan. For Trueloque, we don't so far see it, but it could be either here or on the other side, because there is the gold, so I'm more expecting on the right. Like about there, because usually you don't get such close spawns on Alfheim, and especially on the newer maps you shouldn't be getting that. There's gonna be a bit of scouting by Nyan though, so he's gonna be knowing exactly about the extra resources, and it's a bit unfortunate that Trueloque doesn't know about this gold mine, because it's fairly important, close to his base, so definitely something that he could be going for, and he's at least right now already preparing the temple behind his base, so that he's gonna be limiting at least the chance of the construction from the opponent, and therefore disrupting that early game. Just right now looking at the opportunity here of the oracles, if you could be valoring them and deconstructing, for example, the granary, because that could be potentially screwing the opponent at correct timing. If you're gonna be advancing really quickly, valoring the oracles and deconstructing the granary, basically forcing the villagers to escape. Maybe you don't even need to deconstruct the granary actually at that point. Even though the refighting might be a bit problematic, then you might be in for a bit of a fun. And, kind of interesting if maybe that could be somehow working, I mean. Who knows? Who knows? But definitely it's not done all that often. As the Promethean is gonna be already up because of course of the temple transported all the way into the right flank to prevent the food gathering, which so far is doing really well. and done really well by Nyan, because he forced off this hunt, this one. So trueloque is gonna be back to... Luckily he does have actually plenty of cowies, like really plenty of them. So right now he's having good amount of 1000 plus food still here. And that's gonna be the reconstruction, obviously. Damn good timing. And right now trueloque is gonna be screwed because he's not getting the free Kentaur at all. Really well played by NyanRacingCat, looking at the timing and timer where it's gonna be coming up. And that's exactly what he wanted to achieve, because right now the Kentaur is not gonna be able to freely snipe the Prometheans from the safety of the TC. So Jason is coming up. He's gonna be joined by his friend Odysseus quite soon, right after. But obviously without the temple, that's a huge problem. Because right now what trueloque is gonna be doing, I'm not entirely certain. Because it almost seemed to me that he was hoping to go for the Kentaurs, exactly as we said. But this completely screwed him over, and just really well prepared Nyan and well played overall. So continue with some stragglers. He still does have a bit of wood, at least from that. So obviously Odysseus is gonna be forcing the enemy away from that position, but otherwise he doesn't have exactly all that safe berries. The chickens are a bit better, but he certainly needs the towers upgraded as soon as possible, because without those I don't think his defense is gonna be going all that well at all. Inside the base of Nyan, that's gonna be apparently so far full on counter barracks. No Murmilos are gonna be coming forward at all, so far it's only Turmas apparently. So maybe a few Cairo Ballista could be also coming up. And thank you very much Matrius for the host. That's quite a solid and hefty one. So I hope that everybody is gonna be enjoying some games between Nyan and trueloque in the first round of, or the first round of Bill Gregg Open Tournament. And there's a pretty good chance that after this match is gonna be gone, rather over, until, or rather unless, it's gonna be extremely long. Not entirely all that impossible, it could be a longer one. We could be having another one, because there are plenty of games for this evening, and therefore plenty of Age of Mythology goodness to be still had. So there we are, gonna be right now potentially waiting. I'm really waiting for the towers still. I think they need to come. Even though there's gonna be the construction, it would still be a good one, because you would get the extra resources from it. 200 wood and 100 gold, you don't find it on the street. You cannot get it from the sentry tower by somehow deconstructing it yourself. You need to be getting your friends there, helping you out, the little Prometheans and the god powers of their friend Kronos. But nonetheless, so far it's very well played by Nyan. Just basically pressure absolutely everywhere, all across the map. And the stragglers are almost out, 150 foot left, or rather wood left here. And trueloque probably needs to be continuing a bit more wall in here, because the gold is definitely threatened, and he probably could be even looking at this one. Problem is, he doesn't know about it. I don't think he scouted there since. We know that it was scouted by NyanRacingCat, and I don't think that trueloque has seen it since. So therefore he probably is thinking that this is his only gold mine. There's gonna be another one in the very corner. It's a good combination. That's a very good combination. But problem is that trueloque probably won't be able to get there unless he goes like some kind of Geronimo with a ceasefire to steal the TC pretty much from the enemy power of the Turmas and the Prometheans. And he's gonna be able to get from there. But it seems to me that trueloque is gonna be able to slowly crawl back in, but he needs to be careful about the numbers here. Not to lose, for example, the units all that needlessly. Yet again repeating that the towers would be going a long way for him, as he's having 666 foot in there. What a hellish number for him. And obviously he needs a whole lot more gold from this. So therefore something like pickaxe definitely should be coming forward from him. So far not, unfortunately. Seems that way at this point. But the numbers of the units should be getting better and better. But unfortunately this Hippicon probably could be just as well sent somewhere into some kind of scouting party and duty. Or maybe just basically looking at, for example, back TC to know when the opponent is gonna be switching over into economy. Building crush vulnerability decreased. Temple upgrades being cheaper. That's potentially not too bad. Can see little Promethean having a bit of a problem with the Kataskopos in there. So apparently a bit of walling is coming forward from trueloque. It's gonna be good enough, I think. I think it's gonna be good enough at this point. Well, he's gonna be at least having a few berries still, but otherwise he does have another hunt to the top. But I'm actually really thinking that he hasn't scouted the top side of the map at all. And therefore he doesn't really well know what's waiting for him in that top corner. It's a bit unfortunate for him. So there we are, that's gonna be Military Academy. That's kinda like an interesting idea. He does have plenty of food, so that's probably why he wants to be going for that. And Hoplites do have bonus against Turmas. Problem is, you need to be catching the Turmas first, right? So that's obviously a bit of a problem for him. So you're gonna be right now expecting Probably a bit of a switch from NyanRacingCat into some kind of more raidy part. Like, he was just more camping on the enemy resources up until now, because the enemy didn't have enough units. Right now he's probably gonna have to switch into a bit of a hit and run. He does have the Turmas for that, so that's gonna be fine. And well, he's gonna be going for catapults out of all units. Yet again, that's nice to see, because he can be making them from the Kante barracks. So obviously he doesn't need the military barracks for the Murmillos now. Okay, so that's nice. That is quite nice indeed. You can see he's so far playing fairly standardly. I'm just kind of expecting he should be switching a bit more into Echo at this point. Could we maybe even go in for the front TC here? I mean, like, could be making a bit of sense for him. Nothing being researched. Trueloque, though, getting quite high on the resources. So it's almost as if he was aiming for Heroic Age, but I don't think so. It's only because his economy is a bit skewed and not working as optimally as he would like to, from the previous problems that he was having from trading. And oh well, that's gonna be a solid trading. Had now taken everything away. This one desperately trying to get into the TC. Not well, there we go. That's gonna be right now all of them going back into the straggler tree. Oh, they're gonna be depleting it, rather depleting it almost instantly. And he definitely is right now gonna be having a bit more of a problem completely controlling the army, it seems like, as most of it is all the way onto the left. And his economy is gonna be suffering for it. So he's going for the gold on the left, yet again confirming he doesn't know about this gold. He's just completely missing it the whole time. That's just so sad. That's so incredibly sad, because this really is an excellent gold for him. Even the hunt is excellent, but he just hasn't scouted that part at all. And therefore he doesn't know what kind of good opportunity he's missing there. Well, that's what you get with you, or rather with not having sufficient scouting, unfortunately. Usually it happens, for example, to Egyptians, but nonetheless, it's happening here also to Trueloque as the Zeus. As in the middle, it's gonna be apparently right now continued pressure on the gold mine, which is right now not all that important, but destroying the houses is not such a bad idea. That could be doing something at least a bit. Bit of a bug in the hole here for Nyan. That's gonna be stopped. Not that ideal. Can see he's gonna be right now even housed for a moment, but he was even housed from TC, so it's kind of fine. And he's definitely aiming for Heroic Age. As you can see, Trueloque is also getting housed, but he is not at 115 at all. Okay, so let's have a look. There's gonna be right now raiding all the way to the top, as Nyan has made his way through Trueloque's base, and oh well. Okay, so he's gonna finish with this, there's no problem with that. He does have still the ceasefire in case. So that's kind of fine. Okay, there we go. So, but basically you can look at that. There's basically 25 villages here and there not working at all. That's basically like most of his economy at this stage. So you can already see the economical damage. And obviously Nyan is not suffering anything like that at all, because he's not getting raided. He's still the one applying pressure all the time. Trueloque close by and close by, or the closer and closer to the Heroic Age, whereas Nyan, no? What? What did he invest into so heavily? He's not having medium infantry. Oh, he went for the second DC, alright. I think he should have gone Heroic. Because of how the game is, I think he should have gone Heroic for more tactical advantage. Getting some Satyrs going from Hyperion probably. Or maybe even actually Rhea for Behemoths. They were also buffed in Balance Patch 4.0 with quite a lot more hit points. So for example, having the Temple Summoner at the back and then assaulting the TC. I'm thinking that could have been working really well. But well, he decided not to. He's gonna be delaying his Heroic Age. And that's actually, I'm thinking, giving quite a solid chance to Trueloque, quite frankly. It might be a bit of a tactical mistake, but problem is that Trueloque right now is unfortunately not quick enough with the wall-in. And therefore he's gonna be losing quite a solid portion of villages right now, about like 5 at least, that he has lost in the battles all around, with the dead bodies decomposing already. And well, all the way onto the right flank, good thinking by Trueloque. Gonna be finding the villager, trying to steal the TC for Nyan, and therefore this one is certainly not escaping into safety at all. Okay, so he's dead. Therefore Trueloque maybe even gonna be, he's gonna be taking even a third one. But on the left side, this is looking really dire. I'm not thinking he's gonna be able to keep this alive, unless he basically ceasefires this. No, he's hemorrhaging villages big time at this point, that's not worth it. He's having way too many villages in there. That's gonna be really problematic. He should be probably just trying to eject them as soon as possible. I wonder if he's gonna be trying to maybe even take this DC. and then cast the ceasefire. Because at this point, this is a very good raiding by trueloque. And it seems like he has been able to finally get some kind of army going. And that is gonna be quite problematic for Nyan. Not entirely certain why he didn't at least with half of them run into the manor. If he basically switched it, like split it, two into the manor and two escaping away, there's a pretty good chance that maybe trueloque would be a bit panicking or whatever. But nonetheless, didn't happen. Let's watch the massacre to the top for a moment. Trueloque is refusing the ceasefire because he's smelling blood at the bottom and wants to be killing villages as well. Oh well, oh, there is a way through. No, there isn't a way through. Oh, damn it. They are actually managing to trap themselves, the villages. Okay, that sucked. No, that was actually, they were probably trying to stay in formation and the pathing kind of screwed Trueloque here a bit. But nonetheless, that was quite massive. He lost about like 10-15 villages, I'm expecting, in the last few minutes next to the TC, so it was pretty bad for him. As Nyan, not advancing yet and not advancing still, seems to be quite content in staying in the Classic Rage, but that's not a good idea. Because at this point, the Classic Rage is an advantage for the Greek, if he were getting upgrades, which he isn't. Because his economy is all across the place, obviously, through the brutal raiding that he's still suffering. But well, just gonna confirming and saying again and reiterating, I'm thinking that Nyan should have gone advance faster than the DCs. Well, nonetheless, he did not. Let's see how he's gonna be coming through with it now. He doesn't even have medium catapulty still. So you're gonna be expecting apparently even Maror move to the left side so that he can exactly save the villager. Because the army is coming there in quite high numbers. Being pursued by not small numbers either. But there is gonna be a bit of raiding attempted with one catapultist leader. All the way to the top, gonna be of course moving. It's almost like Trueloque was actually preparing a bit of a maze in there for the raiding party. But of course, all of them are gonna be right now escaping into safety of the TC yet again. But not before. Plenty of them are gonna be dying. As on the left side, the battle didn't go all that well for Trueloque. TC is gonna be finished for 9. He's gonna be at 3. And therefore, there's gonna be still one open and potentially available for Trueloque. Yeah, this is nice from Nyan. If only he knew that Trueloque doesn't know. Therefore, he doesn't need to be even scouting there. But it's correctly played by Nyan. He needs to be paying attention to that. But unfortunately for him, there is an excellent gold mine in the right corner that we have talked about a bit before. And it's really gonna be... it's really gonna be some kind of good bonus and good opportunity for Trueloque, especially looking at the secondary gold here and the TC not being too far away and still haven't ceased fire. That Trueloque could be somehow salvaging this, though it's gonna be extremely hard. You can see the difference in the score, about 500 points. 30 TC already up there from NyanRacingCat, and he's going for watchtowers. I'm thinking he's gonna time shift them into the front. Alluvial Clay on the Promethean for a bit more hit points, actually quite a bit more hit points. Trueloque is trying to raid with horses at the bottom and at the same time with Hopeless destroying the TC on the left. On the left, and that's gonna be kinda close. He definitely needs a bit more army there as soon as possible. That was really a whole lot closer than I think even Nyan thought. Trueloque almost got through it, or rather got away with it, but nonetheless, gonna be right now needing to use the villager time to get the hit points back up, at least for the time being, but otherwise the economical ups are probably gonna be better for Nyan, but not that extremely. Look at that, only pickaxe and plow. For the opponent, handaxe and pickaxe, plow missing. But otherwise, Nyan finally gonna be coming into Heroic Age. Right now, Trueloque is heavily overdoing gold. He goes, yeah. As he needs to be switching into farms, and he needs to be really switching into wood quite heavily at this point. Because he needs to be switching into farmland a whole lot more. He does have plenty of gold, so like half of the villages here could be even... maybe he could even gather the bears. I mean, like, why not? It's still 400 food for free. Definitely could be sending a few villages to finish with the farms, but nonetheless... let's not dwell on that too much. Rhea is on the way, and therefore we're gonna be seeing a few behemoths. I do approve of that for Nyan. He's gonna be probably moving the temple somewhere to the top side, as otherwise it seems that Trueloque finally has scouted this part of the map, and he's gonna be getting not only the hunt, but maybe even the gold finally, as the Hippicons are getting high numbers, but still not getting the medium upgrade, unfortunately, making them immensely better. Immensely, and by that I mean I, double M, and whatever letters are left in the word there. Okay, so right now a few more hopeless. This time it's gonna be probably working because blue is somewhere completely else and on basically the wrong side of the map. So far this is working really well for Trueloque. He's basically luring Nyan into destroying the buildings instead of actually fighting. and destroying villages. So, so far this is delaying tactics really working well. So of course he's gonna be resulting into the TC destroyed, but that wasn't the one with any kind of advance. Astrea is already in, and while at least one of the citizens is gonna be, actually two of them, that's one and two citizens destroyed now. That's kind of nice. That's a good comeback for trueloque for the time being, as finally he's gonna be getting a blow, but NyanRacing are getting closer and closer to a mythic age of his own, as trueloque's so much gold. But yeah, he is not in the next age, and therefore you just cannot do anything with that at all, unfortunately. Just needs to be really sending half of the villages into food at this point, as there's gonna be brother attempt by NyanRacingCat to take the TC on the right flank. They've just been scouted by trueloque. Can see the free behemoth at 625 hit points, and the whole army right now doubling down on him with heavy archers already in. That's gonna be resulting into plenty of archai coming forward, and therefore the hoplites probably shortening their lifespans quite a bit. You just basically imagine if he was getting medium hippicons at least. At this point it wouldn't help, but a bit earlier you'll be having a whole lot more longevity. Yet again a bit of a trap in the forest. That's the second time that trueloque actually falls for this, or falls for this. Game does this to him, that's better said, I guess. But well, enjoy the heavy turmas. You don't exactly see them all that much. Once you're gonna be seeing, for example, the upgrade into heavy, you usually see the Atlanteans be heavily onto the archive. But well, nonetheless, there's the Prometheus, or the Prometheus behemoth, with the Prometheans as well. And unfortunately, Grey Hero's not exactly being on the battlefield anymore. So while he's receiving plenty of punishment, because the 30% melee armor is not entirely too high, it is not too bad still. And he's apparently able to survive for the time being, because he's not even being shot at by the units, and he's even healing. Yeah, he was healing a bit, obviously, in there, and it seems to me that trueloque might be forced into ceasefire here, but he needs to be quick to steal the TC in the meantime, because there's even a citizen, as Nine is already preparing with that. But it seems that apparently with the behemoth death, and dead, there's not much that right now Nine could be following through with. Still more dead villages right now for trueloque, and considering how much he's hemorrhaging lives on the economy, it's fairly impressive he's still even in the game, I guess. Heavy infantry, trueloque, yeah, just a huge amount of gold there. Fortunately for him, for the Greek, it's useless. He cannot use the gold for anything. Even the mythical units don't cost gold until mythic. So that's kind of what really sucks for him. Greeks are more reliant on other resources, especially on wood, before they get into the mythical age. But well, nonetheless, there we go. That's gonna be the settlement. Probably at this point successfully stolen, as on the left side it has been retaken quite a bit before, with palace being built there with a few more military buildings. But so far it's quite a good battle, and quite a tight one, and trueloque definitely showing quite some tenacity and absolutely refusing to die as long as possible. Alright, so the TC definitely needs to be repaired exactly as it is. That's gonna be fine, but trueloque apparently is already thinking that this is going to be already it, and in the end the tenacity was quite commendable. But NyanRacingCat's basic attention and basic raiding all across the map from the very beginning was paying dividends, and the hundreds at this point almost villages lost that trueloque suffered, well, they in the end had to be noticeable somewhere, and they were. And they definitely were. Well, nicely played though. That was quite nice Kronos from Nyan. Really good pressure all across the map. Very well played, switching from left and right side, blocking both food sources at the same time in the early classical age. It was nicely done. Can see even right now switching with the behemoths rather from the left side somehow. Even though he doesn't have the temple here, so I don't know how he did it, but doesn't matter much. Let's have a look into the postgame. And it's gonna be right now everything won by Nyan, and it's gonna be 10,000 all around. Yeah, you can see the difference in the economy, just obviously gonna be huge because of the number of wills that trueloque lost across the course of the game. But still, the military results are not too bad, and I cannot help that if trueloque got especially medium hippicons when he had the huge number of them, the game could have been quite a bit different, and maybe he would have a whole lot more time to actually get back. You can see 338 though, very early advance, it's almost a crush. Almost a crush right there. But Nyan, he does know how to play his Kronos. Oh, can see that brutality here on the raiding from about 45 or whatever down to 35, so like 10 villages dead here. That was around the TC there. Oh well, GG.